Editing shader attributes. In this lesson, we will learn how to set properties of the material applied to an object. By default, this object is created with a material named Lambert 1. Now, let us apply blend to this object. To edit the properties of this material, go to the attribute editor and click on blend 1. Now blend 1 properties are displayed. In this, under type option, we can change the material. In this way, we can set the desired material. Here we took blend. Under the common material attributes, click on the color to open the color chooser. The color chosen in this palette will be applied to the object. We can adjust the color tint by changing hue, saturation, variant, and etc. After completing color settings, click OK. By adjusting the transparency slider, we can adjust the opacity or transparency of the object. In the same way, we can adjust the ambient color of the object by moving this slider. We can see that preview of adjustment in the material sample box. In the same way, by adjusting the incandescence, we can increase the brightness or lighting of the shader. In the same way, we can also adjust the eccentricity. In rendering, if we increase the eccentricity, we can observe the increase in brightness. If we decrease, we can see the decrease in material sample. In the same way, specular color. This decides the color of the reflection. For example, here we select yellow color. In the same way, by increasing or decreasing the specular roll-off, we can control the spreading and eccentricity. In this way, by setting the properties of the material, we can set the color and reflection of the object. In the special effects, we can increase glow and intensity like this. In the next lesson, we will learn how to texture an object.